Welcome everyone to the University Fest. Let me ask you a question. Who here value the education the most important the most? Please raise your hand. Yeah, that's right. And let me ask another question. How would you choose your university?
The best one.
The best one, right?
Ranking.
It has to be like the first rank, something like that, right? That's right. So today I'm so excited to being here to be the admission staff of Howard University. And today I would like to first let me introduce myself and my friends. Okay, my name is Jackie and I'm the admission committee of Howard University, and this is my partner Wes. He is an alumni of Howard University. So today I would like you guys to take a look carefully on what I'm going to present, because it is very useful for you to choose your university. And welcome to the best university in the world, Howard University. Let me start with a little bit of history of Howard University, because some of you guys might not know what it is. Howard University is very good in teaching, learning, doing research, and developing the leader. In every year, Howard University has created many professional and qualified students. And you know what? There are more than 20,000 students who graduate from Howard every year. And Howard University has more than 360,000 alumni from all around the world. Okay, let's go to the reputation of Howard University. You know what? Howard University is the oldest university in the world. It has an age of 381 years old. You may see that it is very old, so it might have a reason with old fashioned, right? But it's not. It's always developed over time and over time. It's always used the modern lesson on teaching. And Howard University is the university that has largest endowment in the world, with 34.5 billion dollars. So you don't have to worry about funding anymore. Howard University will give you the full funding on your research or on your project. All you need is your effort and willing to do it. Another thing is, this is my very cool, because you know what? 8 US president graduated from Howard University. The US president, just imagine that really intelligent, smart, and really cool, like the president. They should be like carefully choose the university, right? So let's make sure that Howard University is the best university that have the most U.S. president candidate. Sorry. And as you guys are the fresh, will be the freshie very soon, right? So there are more than 400 freshman advisors from Howard University, which will provide you as like something like partner who can advise you with your study plan or like how you live in Howard University. And you might see that Howard University is the best university with like very less people who came in, and they have to be like talent and intelligent, like but it might be like have the difficulty in graduation, right? Some of you guys might think like that. But it is not, because as from the record, 98% of students graduated from Howard University. So no worry about that. Just put all your effort on your study and just enjoy your life in university. And another one is freshman seminars. There are more than 130 freshman seminars in Harvard University for you as a freshman. So you don't have to like experience it by yourself. Just take a look at the speaker carefully and just like stay on. Now let's talk about our alumni. As I have said earlier, there are more than 360,000 alumni graduated from Harvard University. And these three guys, I just pick up to make you imagine that what is the outcome of Harvard University. The first guy is Barack Obama. You guys might know him already. He is the 44th United States president. And you know him as like the very persuasive leader and very good for the speaker. Another guy is Bill Gates. Do you know like Microsoft that you use on your laptop? That's him. He created it. He is the co-founder of Microsoft company. Another guy is Mark Zuckerberg. He is a great billionaire with very young age. He is the founder of the CEO of Facebook. Actually, he didn't get it from Harvard, but he spent his 2 years on Harvard and like getting the idea and forming the Facebook company. Let's talk about job and career. You may see like when you are in the university and just study, it might seem very boring, right? So it will be better if you have like getting experience while you also study. For the record, 40% of Harvard students have almost 40% of Harvard students have like we call it a part-time job. Almost 80% of students in Harvard University have part-time job. That guarantee because for the location of Harvard University is located in the city, and there are many small company and big company around, so you can find a part-time job easily. And next, I would like to invite with the alumni to talk about what is the life in Harvard University. With
here, Zaki. Please give a big hand to Zaki. So I'm very excited and feel so great to talk with you about this topic. As an alumni, I just graduated in 2018 in this year, and I'm planning to study in a master degree in Harvard about the education. And this topic that I will let you know is very important because if you choose one university, it means that you have to stay there in 4 years, right? At least 4 years, right? It means that you have to spend a lot of time, and if you choose, you have to choose wisely. I will give you a lot of information. This is very important for the student to choose the university. For the first, somebody asked me about the campus. This is the Harvard campus. You know that many university they separate from the city. When you stay in that university, you feel that you don't can go to shopping, go to concert is very hard. But Harvard is in the heart of Cambridge, as we said. And this is Cambridge, and this is Harvard. You can see that Harvard, they have a place about 5,000 acres, and they have like a river to separate Harvard in the, to the upper side and the lower side. And this is for the Harvard campus. And you talk about the upper side, the main is about the Harvard Yard. This is all about the building that you will study in there. And when you finish your class, you can see that this is we call the house. And in Thai, some of you know it's a dormitory, right? But in Harvard, we call house. The house is very near to the university, and they have like a Harvard Square, which you can do go to shopping with your friends and go to hang out. It's very special that why Harvard is very special, because they have a lot of endowment. You know, endowment is like they have a lot of money to build many things that which is the best in the world. For example, this is for the library. You go for the academic year, right? And you have to study for 4 years. I think that is also important because they are the largest university library and they are the oldest library system. There are about 76 libraries and it's about 80 million volumes. It's about the books. Someone said that if you spend the whole life in the Harvard library and you read a book, you can finish it because it's a lot. And about the museums, there are like three fields of museum. First, culture, science, and about digital collection. It's about the 20 museum. Why important? For example, when you study in the science, I think you want to see the real stuff, right? If you can to understand more about it, and you, they have their own museum. You don't have to go to France or England to study about museum, but you have your own museum. That's very cool. And this is for the Harvard look. Every university, I think that they have like a their signature, and it's about the building. This is the old fashioned. Harvard stands for 300 years, you know? And why they can still that? Because they have a very strong structure. This is for the old fashioned, they built from the red brick, you know, red brick. And this is for the new fashion, but they have store like old fashioned plus with the new fashion. This is the Harvard Square. Harvard Square is like the shopping mall. The shopping mall which you can go with your friend after class. You can go and shopping something. And this is for the Harvard Stadium. It's very good facility. You think about this stadium. I'm Thai student and I got a chance to study in Harvard, right? First, I heard about that Harvard have a stadium. Wow, it's very cool because they can like make their own competition and they have lots of thousands of people come to here and to watch the competition. And for the Harvard football locker room, Harvard, they very give importance to the sport. And you can see that if you like to play sport, they have the room for you. And this is for the athletic center. You want to go to work out or something after class, they have a lot and really large for every student in the Harvard. And if you want to tour, right, I think some of you say Thai and you want to see that how Harvard looks. You don't have to go to Harvard and see it. You can see from the website. This website, you can go and click that. They have like a virtual tour. It's like a real tour. You can go and you see every corner of Harvard. And they have like a guide. This is the guide for you to let you know that what this corner is about. The most important part that I would like to tell you is about the life in Harvard. You know that life in the university is very beautiful. And I will give you some idea that what is Harvard is very special. Here, who is have watched about the Harry Potter movie? Can you raise your hand? Right? All of you, right? It's very famous movie. I think that if you watch Harry Potter, you can remember about the house. And in that movie, they have four houses, and Harry Potter live in, can you remember? Gryffindor, right? Gryffindor. What? Not right. It's okay. Okay, it's okay. But however, I will tell that it's the same pattern because they have the house. This is the house in the Harvard, and they have the scene same theme of the Harry Potter movie. For the example, the Adam's House. There you have like the Harvard Housing Day, and you can choose. You cannot choose. You can form your team like two up to seven people, but they will random you in your house. It's like in the Harry Potter, the house select you, right? You not select your house. And for the sport, very famous sport is the American football sport. And very famous competition in that they hold every year is about Harvard versus Yale University. This is very famous university in the Ivy League. And they have like a competition every year. Okay, and the last one. I love Harvard because they are all like a diversity, and I feel comfortable to live with all of my faith, all of many nationality. They say that 55.1% they are white, and they are 16.6% they are Asian. We are Asian, right? And you can feel comfortable. Asian, they come from many countries like China, Japanese, Japan, or South Korean, and Thai also. And you feel comfortable to meet your friend from the same diversity. So, and the last one, Jackie will coming up and tell you about how to get to the best university, how to get to Harvard. Please welcome Jackie.
Here you can see that Harvard is a lovely place that. Harvard is a lovely place that you guys might just imagine that you were there and like you study there and doing activity over there. It's happy life, right? But the most important thing that you can do Harvard is study, right? So there are 12 faculties that you can choose, like business school, dentist, medicine, art and science. That you can choose for your study plan, right? And I would like to give you a tip, like how you get into Harvard easily and just not going to anyone, right? Because it might be a little bit competition. So the first one that I would like to advise you is the grade and GPA. As you know that great, and GPA, you have to did very well on your high school, right? So just, you still have a time to do it. Just study hard and work on it because it might be one of the factors that Harvard will choose you. Another one is the test score. You know it as like SAT score and TOEFL score. Just, just take like tuition course or something like that, or like I advise you to take the test like twice, because the first time you just get to see the paper first, so the second time you can read it the best way. And another one, the third one is extra curriculums and awards. Harvard University didn't choose the only intelligent people, but the student who have a talent and like have the willing to do something for our world, that's what Harvard like. Another one is recommendation letters. These letters you can ask any of your teachers to write it for you. And I advise, I would like to give you advice to like ask the teacher that you are close to and like the for example, like when you go for the competition, something like that, you can ask him because he knows you the best and because he will support you when you're doing competition. And the last one is personal statement. It is simply an essay question that Howard will give you if you want to enroll. So, Aaron, you should write it on your own. Like, don't lie to it. Just wrote down everything that you think. And and here are the application requirement. The first one is universal for the application. Another one is ACT or SAT, which is no maximum and minimum for sending this application, but this is the best. TOEFL as well. If this one you don't have to take if you are the person who use English as the first language, but you guys are Thai, right? So you have to take it and do it the best as well. Another one is high school transcript, your high school, like the fourth, fifth, and sixth grade. Ninth, tenth, and twelfth grade for Thai. Right? The last one is teacher recommendation. You can, as I said, you can ask for any teachers. And here I want you to see that who are your competitors. There are three class. The first one is world class. The world class is something like if you send the application, the 90% of those people will be enrolled in Harvard University. Those students are like something like Superman who is really intelligent, something like that. So it's like a little bit low competition. And the middle one is strong, well-rounded. It is 3.2% that you will be selected from this group. It is like you are not that intelligent, but you are not like having the too low gain, something like 3.0 GPA, something like that. And another one is not qualified. You still get like 1% to be selected, pick up from the group. But if you see something like this, you might see that enroll in Harvard University is very hard. But I just want to tell you that if you are the person who would like to change something in the world and have a, something like doing activity, I call it as like activity student who always active and doing something like that all the time, Harvard might choose you as the Harvard student. Here are the tuition fee that I would like to show you. This one you don't have to look at it, but this one is your tuition fee. It's $62,000. You might see it's really high, right? But I just want to show you that Harvard has financial aid. So if you have like financial problem, you can take it because like from the whole Harvard University, 70% of those students get financial aid from Harvard University, and those students who get financial aid pay the money less than those who are in the state universities. And next, I would like to invite the Wes again to talk about like promotion, something like that. Wes,
thank you. Okay, and to the last of the presentation today, I will give you very good news for you to come to this fair, because I'm like a Chinese student who graduates from Harvard, right? And I contact with the Harvard, and then I contact with the Thai government to give you some promotion. When for Thai student, we say that if you apply now, like you try harder enough and you get to Harvard, we'll give you like a 100% scholarship for one person. And the other, the rest of you have like a 4% who will get like a 50% of. Okay. And this is for the promotion, and you can ask me later about this. Okay. Thank you for your presentation. But the last one, I will tell you what. They say that knowledge is the most important currency of the 21st century. And I think you will join Harvard. Thank you.